the abolition of the Khilafah on the 3rd of March 1924 is located in a place called India. But even the Indian scholars of Islam are not aware of it. Even they are not aware of it. When the attack on the Khilafah was taking place in the 1916, 17, 18 period, then Indian ulama, at that time the Indian Muslim community was one of the most influential Muslim communities in the world. And the Indian Muslim community was led by leaders who knew Islam and lived Islam. Men like Maulana Muhammad Ali Jauhar, Maulana Shaukat Ali, Maulana Sayyid Suleiman Nadwi, Mufti Kifayatullah, men who knew Islam and lived Islam. And they wanted to get rid of British imperial rule in Britain, in India. So that when they got rid of the British, they could restore Islamic rule over Muslims. That's all they wanted. And so they established a movement which they called the Khilafat movement. Harakatul Khilafat. Harakatul Khilafat. The Khilafat movement. When they established the Khilafat movement and it began to mobilize the Muslim masses, the body which was sleeping is now waking up for revolutionary struggle to preserve the Khilafah in Istanbul. We also want the Hindus, we want to get rid of the British, and we want to restore Hindu rule over the Hindus. So there's a conversion of interest here. So Gandhi, who later became known as Mahatma Gandhi, Gandhi approached the leadership of the Khilafat movement and he said to them, listen, the same thing you want, the same thing I want. So why don't we join forces? Will you allow me to join the Khilafat movement? This constituted the most dangerous of all threats that Western civilization have ever experienced in its entire period of colonization of mankind. Because the Western objective was to demolish every existing state structure in the world and replace it with the secular state. So that eventually the secular state could be brought under the umbrella of a League of Nations and eventually a United Nations, and this would be political globalization as well. Between 1920 and 1924, the Khilafat movement was building up steam at an alarming rate. And by 1924, the British had calculated, we have to get rid of this Khilafat movement. And the only way we can think of now is to abolish the Khilafat. And so they put the pressure on Mustafa Kemal. As soon as the Khilafat was abolished, the Khilafat movement in India began to lose steam.
In 1918, Maulana Muhammad Ali Jauhar and Maulana Shaukat Ali launched the Khilafat movement to protect the Ottoman Empire. Gandhi linked the issue of Swaraj with the Khilafat issue to associate Hindus with the movement. Muslims and Hindus worked side by side to boycott British goods and British law. Large protest rallies were organized throughout the subcontinent. In 1922, when the movement was at its climax, Gandhi called it off, making the excuse that some national volunteers were responsible for the murder of 21 policemen in the Chora Chori.
In that same year, the secularly minded, the brown-skinned Englishmen parading as Muslims, of whom the prince of them all was the grandfather of the present Aga Khan, Karim Aga Khan's grandfather. They now restore an organization called the All India Muslim League. Huh? The All India Muslim League is led by men who don't know Islam and don't live Islam. And these are the people who now wage a struggle for the liberation of the Muslims from British rule to be replaced, not with rule of Islam, oh no, but rather by the rule of the secular Republic of Pakistan, and the Secular Republic of India, so that Pakistan and India could be embraced within the community of secular nation states.
بأسلوب حكيم فقدم صورة تغني وتكفي عن إطناب وإسهاب سئيم ولكن الخديم يعز وصفه فحسبك منه بالفهم السليم فقبلك أفرغ الأدباء فيه مقالات من الدر النظيم وما بلغوا بذلك ما يساوي حقيقة ذلك العظيم أحل الله روح الشيخ قربا من المهموم الوجه الوسيم وقربه إليه كل حين وجازاه من الفضل العميم وبوأه به ظلا ظليلا بأفراح تلذ وبالنعيم وعمر صالحا فينا زمانا طويلا في سرور مستديم بجاه المصطفى دامت عليه صلاة الله خالقنا الكريم لا تقريض اللهج القويم شيخ محدين لا تهي به الكلمات رضي الله عنه وأرضاه
Oui, c'est... Il donne... اخواني اللي لقيناي بنيو سبسو ريسبسيون بنو تلي الا بنيو سبسو مع قال دي بوك ني مع قال لا لا دا فني لون مون نغنال ما وليك رك ني ما يوبنت سي ياو دي واخني امنا نو مبكت بو ري كو خامني نيو فك بس ويو بو تول ني نيو فك بس خيوول بو تول ني نيو با تك سن تانك سي بس سي توبا سي بس بو ري بي ليغي موم لا ما دون واخ ني نالا كو جوتالي ليغا خامني ني نغي جانغ بيد ييغا خامني بيد نون كسي شحمد بامبا
كله نحن سا dites-lui qu'on va lui demander la permission de retourner à Dakar, mais avant on voudrait qu'il prie Allah pour sa majesté, pour le prince héritier, pour la famille royale, pour le Maroc, et pour une prospérité des relations
maroco-sénégalaises. Man delu su nexu yalla Dakar pour jëlaat avion bi ñibbi Maroc ndax mom dara taxuko ñew lu dul li avion dafa wacc comme xaju guddi la won mu bayyi ba juroom ñett wax jot mu jubal ci Touba ñew yendu ci su démé dafay jubalat légui dajala ay bagasam delu Maroc waye néna mi ngi fatali rek limu waxoon ci suba moy amna mbékté bu reuy ñew ci bës bi bokk ak ñun waye nak néna gëm nañ ni bës bi bësu yiw la motax mi ngi lay ñaan nga ñaanal bu baax Mohamed Cisse néna ñaanal bu baax njabootu Hassan Bey yépp ak njabootu Moulay Driss yépp néna ñaanal bu baax bu am Maroc néna Maroc ba jàmm yàgg sax fa alal bi mu gàññ sax fa ak xéwal sax fa néna nag waaye buñ fàtte diggante Maroc ak Sénégal néna nga ñaan si ba diggante bi fu mu demoon si ay xéwal rek mu weesu ko.
On a été honoré, immensément honoré de cette visite et on gardera le souvenir dans le trône de nos esprits pour toute nos vies.
Nena ñeu bi ñu ñeu reuy na lool ci ñom waye nak terre bi ak liñ fi fekk nek na ci ñom cieur bo xamni xam nañu fan la tambalé waye xamul fan lay yam nena li wurtu wor seen biir xol gannaaw bis bu gannaaw dundu gaay ngey wéy duma fatte bis bi mukk waaw bis bu reuy la ci ñom.